Good evening, Racine Raiders fans. And again, it's time for our interview with head coach Wilbert Kennedy, brought to you by Educators Credit Union. Find out more at www.ecu.com. And Wilbert, boy, I tell you, that Serpico Memorial Stadium in Melrose Park, that place can be nightmarish for the Raiders, has been in the past. And the way that game started out last week with the snap over the head of TJ and then them recovering, getting that touchdown to take the lead, I was having bad, bad flashbacks to the last time I think we were there against the Chicago Chaos.
Yeah, that's the game we lost. We didn't give up a defensive touchdown. They were all special team touchdowns. Yeah, that brought back some terrible, terrible memories. Not again. Yeah, that was a moment I would love to take back.
Your team righted the ship, though, again on the road. You know, you're going to face adversity, and there are a lot of guys on the team that probably remember that game against the Chaos, but your team was able to overcome that early adversity and rattle off 35 unanswered points. Boy, I tell you, Howard Triplett, he just is really at a whole other level than what we saw him at almost 2 years ago, I think.
Yeah, you know, I kept, a lot of people ask about Howard, a lot of different, you know, interviews and just people in general. And, you know, all I can say about that young man is, you know, he gets better every year. I tell him, I go, you haven't reached your peak, and you're just going to continue to get better. He works extremely hard in the off season. I mean, you could just tell in the development of his body from, you know, his first year to what he looks like now. He's put in a lot of hard work. He's become a student of the game. You know, the questions he asks, the things that he sees, you know, Howard has turned into quite the football player, you know, and it's scary how good he's actually going to get because he's young. I believe Howard's like 24, you know, it's scary how good he's going to be.
And besides the physical aspect too, the emotional aspect with Howard, I think, is one thing I've been most impressed to be able to watch in his time with the Raiders, because when I first saw him on our first road trip, I'm like, I don't know that guy's Raider material. And he has just really worked to really develop himself into not just a really good football player, but a really good person.
Well, you know, when Howard came to us, he was a kid, you know, he was 18, 19 years old, just like any other kid would be at that age, you know? So, you know, he's developing into a fine young man. He's a captain of the team right now. He's one of the captains. He's shown great leadership at such a young age, you know, through his efforts and his actions, you know. So, you know, Howard, always been fond of him. You know, I keep telling the story when Howard first came, when we first saw him, and some of the comments he made. He was the fastest guy out there, and he was the best football player out there. And that's when we still had Tyrone. And I said, I think I got somebody that can outrun you. But you know, we were actually going to cut him, but every practice he did one thing, you know, like let's give him another practice. And I thank God that we did, because you know, it wasn't cockiness that he was trying to relay to us. You know, it was confidence in himself, and he didn't know anybody there. And, you know, I'm glad, you know, he stood up for himself, and he wanted to let us know that, you know, he could be part of this team. And yeah, his maturity level gets better every year. You know, he's getting a little bit older. He's really taken on that leadership role in the team. Guys listen to him. Guys love him. So, you know, I'm very fond of Howard. I can't say enough about him.
I'm there with you too, Coach. Looking ahead tonight, Lincoln Way Patriots, a rivalry that's revived, always a good game. I don't know that they have lost at historic Horlick Athletic Field, and they haven't looked like the same Lincoln Way team. Tony Powell has been a little inconsistent through the first couple of weeks, but this is a team that they have the talent, and they can, at some point it's going to click, you would imagine. And I'm imagining you're hoping that doesn't happen here tonight.
I'm really hoping that it doesn't. I mean, Tony's such a nightmare. I get tired of watching him play, but I love to watch him play, if you know what I mean. He runs this scheme very, very well. He's a great quarterback, but what he does it so well, and he's so smart, and he's such a problem, you know, and he's a very patient quarterback. And especially at this level, that's hard to find. And when you have somebody's patient with the weapons that he has at his disposal, he's just such a problem. So I'm not paying any attention to last week or whatever issues they may have had. There's a long history with them as far as being a dominant football team. They have a lot of pride. They got great athletes down there, a good program. And, you know, they were off for a couple of years, you know. So, you know, not being in action because of last year and, the year before, they had closed shop for a year. So, you know, they got to get back in their stride too, playing together again, because, you know, they spread out. So the guys went to other teams and so forth. But there's going to be a moment where it all comes together for them. I'm hoping it's not Saturday, but but I would suspect that you're going to see a much different Patriot team Saturday than you're going to see that you saw in the previous weeks.
Well, and you're blessed. You get to play him twice this season, the last week of the year too, which could have some sort of seeding implications potentially for the playoffs.
Yeah, it's funny how that works out, right? Yeah, because, you know, I really want to play him twice in a year, but, you know, hey, I like to gamble. No, you know, it's one of those things. You want to play the best of the best teams and the best guys. I mean, that's why you're here. You know, if you want to be the big fish in a little pond, and, you know, you want to go out there and beat teams every week, you know, by 30, 40, 50 points, you know, that's not football. That's not why we do this. You know, you play for competition, you know, you want to be tested, you know, you want to find your breaking points, how far you can push yourself. You know, that's the essence of a true athlete. So, you know, to be able to play them twice in a year, you know, I like it. I like playing good competition. So, and the guys like it, you know. You don't learn anything by playing teams that are, you know, not having such a good season, or they don't quite have the personnel that you have, because you don't learn anything from that. You know, you can have a terrible offensive game and score 42 points or whatever, and not learn anything at all from that game. But you can learn a lot from a game when you play a good team and you only win by a couple, you know. So I always want to play a competition. I always want to play up to it. I don't want to dance around it. I don't want to sidestep it. So yeah, I think it's great. I looked at the schedule and I go, yeah, I like this. So I'm on board.
All right, Coach. What are your keys for victory here in this one against Lincoln Way?
Well, the big thing is, you know, we got to play mistake-free football in this game. You know, they have too much talent, and their football knowledge is just so high that if you give too many breaks, too many mistakes, they're going to capitalize on it, and it's going to hurt you. So we got to overcome that. We're going to have to control the football, basically keep them off the field. And then the last thing is, you know, our defense has been playing great. Special teams played better last week. We got to win the special teams battle. We improved last week. It still needs to get better. But special teams are going to make us and break us in this game.
All right, Coach. Well, thanks for your time. Good luck tonight against the Lincoln Way Patriots and trying to stay out of the loss column in the Mid-States Football League here.
Yeah, I would prefer that. I mean, that would be a good strategy.
If you want to keep coaching, right? That's the key there.
Yeah, if I want to keep coaching, I don't want to get replaced. We should probably win. Yes, I agree.
All right, that was head coach Wilbert Kennedy on our interview with the head coach, brought to you by Educators Credit Union. Find out more about Educators at www.ecu.com. When we come back, we'll take a look at the starting lineups, the Racine Raiders and the Lincoln Way Patriots, a good rivalry revived here for the first time in a few years at historic Horlick Athletic Field. We'll see you in about a minute.